कौन कौन से एरियाज हैं? वी हैव मैक्रो इकोनॉमी विच कवर्स बिटवीन 60 to 75 मार्क्स. वी हैव एग्रीकल्चर एरिया, अगेन इट कवर्स 70 to 75 मार्क्स. इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी दैट इज 50 to 60 मार्क्स. एंड इफ वी कंबाइन ऑल ऑफ दीज थ्री, इफ वी कंबाइन ऑल दीज थ्री, देन अराउंड 70 to 75% पेपर इज डन, राइट. सो आउट ऑफ 250 मार्क्स अराउंड 180 to 200 मार्क्स इज कमिंग फ्रॉम दीज थ्री एरियाज ओनली, राइट. बट दैट डज नॉट मीन दैट यू कैन इग्नोर साइंस एंड टेक, एनवायरमेंट, डिजास्टर. तो इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि आप ये एरियाज को छोड़ दो. व्हाई? बिकॉज द पेपर इज कंपल्सरी इन नेचर. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कंपल्सरी? ईच एंड एवरी क्वेश्चन इज कंपल्सरी, राइट. ईच एंड एवरी क्वेश्चन इज कंपल्सरी इन नेचर. इफ यू लीव वन क्वेश्चन यू विल लूज मार्क्स. इफ यू लीव वन क्वेश्चन एंड यू गुड हैव गोट 3 marks, 4 marks in that question, you are at a disadvantageous position. ठीक है, तो आपको साइंस एंड टेक, एनवायरमेंट और डिजास्टर, इसको भी ध्यान में रखना है. यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड दीज थ्री एरियाज ऑल्सो. द वेटेज ऑफ दीज थ्री एरियाज इज समवेयर बिटवीन 20% एंड मैक्सिमम अप टू 30%, राइट. बट अगेन आई एम सेइंग वी कैन नॉट इग्नोर दीज एरियाज, राइट. वी कैन नॉट इग्नोर दीज एरियाज. You can keep asking your doubts or you can keep giving your comments in the chat box. I have no issues. Okay? So that will show that you are not sleeping. This is a afternoon time. So you might be feeling sleepy, many of you. So be active. This will be an interactive session. Now let us see the 2019 UPSC subject wise breakup of the paper. Na? जो लेटेस्ट एग्जाम है हम उसकी बात करते हैं. इन द 2019 यूपीएससी फ्रॉम द इकोनॉमिक 50 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन वाज आस्क्ड, है ना. तो जिस चीज से सबसे ज्यादा लोग डरते हैं, पीपल आर अफ्रेड ऑफ इकोनॉमी एंड इकोनॉमी इज फॉर्मिंग ओनली 20% ऑफ द टोटल मार्क्स. सो यू शुड नॉट वरी, राइट. देयर इज अ मिसकंसेप्शन दैट GS3 मींस इकोनॉमी. This is a big misconception, and that is why you keep reading economy, 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 and finally in the examination you find only 50 marks out of 250 marks, right? So you should keep in mind economy is not equal to GS3. GS3 is not equal to economy, right? Yes, agriculture is, you know, sometime part of the economy. We can say that agriculture is part of the economy, but still. It is also occupying just 50 to 60 marks in the last year paper. So even if we combine both of them, even then the total weightage is approximately 40%, right? So GS3 is not equal to economy and agriculture. It is not a majority of the portion. If we see internal security, which is a, you know, most ignored area, we take it to be granted. हम सोचते हैं कि current affairs पढ़ लेंगे काम हो जाएगा. हम सोचते हैं कि कोई छोटी सी बुक पढ़ लेंगे उससे काम हो जाएगा, राइट. सो दिस इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी व्हिच इज इग्नोर्ड वेरी ऑफन, इट आल्सो गिव्स 50 मार्क्स, राइट. सो यू शुड नॉट अंडरएस्टिमेट द पावर ऑफ इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी. सिमिलरली इकोलॉजी, एनवायरमेंट, डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट, दे आर आल्सो कंबाइंडली, दे आल्सो गिव यू 50 मार्क्स इन द 2019, एंड साइंस एंड टेक 40 मार्क्स, राइट. सो वन थिंग इज क्लियर that each and every area is important. And there is a good news. Good news kya hai? In the economy, for getting these 40% marks, you need to read around 200 plus topics, right? In case of internal security, to get 50 marks, you need to read maximum 50 topics. Maximum 50. So can you see input-output ratio? Are you getting? Say yes in the chat box if you are getting what I'm saying. Can you see the input-output ratio? In the internal security, you get 50 marks question just by reading 50 topics. In the economy and agriculture, you get 40% questions, but for that you have to read 200 plus topic, and this is the minimum limit. 200 is the minimum. You might have to read even 300 topics, and you need to have very critical analysis also, right? I am not saying please ignore economy. I am saying, what I'm saying is, please don't underestimate the other areas, and you should not worry if you are having difficulty in the economy, right? So that is my point. Now, so Nasreen, I will be discussing each and every area, right? I will be discussing each and every area, internal security also, science and tech, environment, in this session. I will discuss what are the key areas, what should be the approach, what are the questions asked in 2019. So you should just listen to the session and you will get everything, right? Great. Now, 2019 key observations. And there are some observations which we can make from the 2019 paper. First of all, the current affairs of 2 years has been covered. Not only last 1 year, but one more year has been covered, right? So you have to follow last 2 years current affair, right? Some micro areas have been focused in the 2019, right? So friends, if we see the pattern of this examination, the pattern changed from 2013. This GS3 paper was separately introduced in the 2013. 2013 mein ye paper alag se start kiya gaya tha. From 2013 to 2017, they were focusing primarily on the macro aspects, hai na? Wo broad questions pooch rahe the. They were asking broad questions. What are the challenges in the Indian economy? What should be the solution? Or they were asking about the agriculture sector. What are the challenges in the irrigation? What should be the solution? So they were focusing on the macro aspect. Now they have started focusing upon the micro aspect. They are asking about what is the cyber dome, which is a initiative of one of the state, that is a Kerala. What are the scientist names who have, like, the contributions of the scientists like M.S. Swaminathan, Bose Einstein, right? So now they are going much more deeper, micro. What is a hazard zone mapping in the disaster management? So now they are going deep and deep, right? So you should also frame your strategy accordingly. Okay? Then many questions are being repeated, right? So micro areas are being asked. That means little bit difficulty, but the good news is that the questions are being repeated, right? Questions repeat ho rahe hain, for example, from the inclusive growth. Every alternative year, you will get one question on the inclusive growth, right? GST, favorite area of the UPSC, both for the prelims and mains. Traditional knowledge, that was asked in 2015 and again asked in 2019. Myanmar border issue, asked in 2013 and again asked in 2019, right? So it is known that you have to prepare only new areas, but you should also go through all the papers from 2013 to 2019. If you go through these papers, then you will definitely get some edge in few questions, right? So aapko kya karna hai, jo previous year questions hai usko bhi dhyan mein rakhna hai, because they can also be repeated. Then now the focus is upon the government schemes also, right? So they are asking about food processing sector. So they asked the question about the PM Sampada Yojana in 2019. They asked the questions about national watershed management, PDS. In 2018, they asked the question about the horticulture mission, right? So you should also be well versed with the latest government scheme. You should also do the critical analysis. What are the achievements of those schemes, challenges, what steps should be taken by the government to improve upon that, right? So are you getting, my friends? Say yes if you are getting what I'm saying. Any queries so far? Say yes in the chat box if you are getting what I'm saying. Okay, great. Great, great. Wonderful. Internal security is important. I have already told you. Internal security is important. Definitely. Great. Chaliye. Now, what are the pitfalls and traps while preparing for the GS3, right? So I have many students who come to me and they say, sir, I have been appearing in this examination from last many years. I have been giving this GS mains examination from my past many years and my score is around 100 marks only out of the 250 marks. Sir, what is the reason why I am not able to improve the score? So there are some pitfalls which are there, right? So most of us think GS3 is equal to economy. I already told you it is not so. GS3 is also not equal to current affairs. This is very, very critical, right? So if you are preparing the GS3 just by reading the newspaper or just by solving answer writing questions and you say that I am preparing for the GS, it is a haphazard preparation. It is not a systematic preparation. If you want to do systematic preparation, you should have minimum 500 words on each and every topic of the syllabus, right? So आपको करंट अफेयर के बेसिस पर टॉपिक्स चूज करने हैं कि कौन सा टॉपिक इंपॉर्टेंट है एंड यू हैव टू आल्सो फॉलो द करंट अफेयर बट जस्ट बाय कवरिंग करंट अफेयर GS3 इज नॉट डन. GS3 नीड्स समथिंग मोर देन करंट अफेयर. इट नीड्स द बैकग्राउंड. इट नीड्स ईच एंड एवरी टॉपिक ऑफ द सिलेबस प्रिपेयर्ड इन वेरी डिटेल, राइट? Then you might say, sir, I have a lot of content information. I have been preparing for this examination for past many years. Sir, I can't read anything new. My friend, I'm not saying you should read something new. What I'm saying is you should structure your preparation. You should make your own notes, which have the static area plus the current affairs, right? Every topic, if you prepare in just one page or two page, then you can revise those one or two page in the examination, right? Now there are some areas which are most ignored, static portion. Like for example, there is a topic of liberalization of Indian economy. If we are not covering these type of static areas, the problem is that our answer writing becomes very average. For example, if there is a question on the public sector versus private sector, which sector is important, then we should give the background of what was the status at the time of independence. At the time of independence, the private sector was very weak, therefore public sector was given the importance. Then in 1991 we realized that public sector is facing big losses, so we cannot give the prime importance to the public sector. So we opened up our economy for the private sector. But in the recent years, even the private sector is showing its negative symptoms, right? There are a lot of corruption scandals, these willful defaulters, right? Then there are corporate governance issues in case of Tata, in case of Infosys, right? So all these things you should know. Then these areas are also given in the economic survey. For example, in the economic survey of 2018-19, this private versus public debate was given very deeply. So if there is a question in the mains 2020 about the public versus private debate, you should give all this background. That is how you will increase your marks. My friends, if you just write the recent developments, you will get only average marks. You will get only 100 marks out of 250. You cannot get 140, 150 marks out of 250. Are you getting? Say yes if you are getting. Great, great. Chaliye. NCRT is also very important. 11th NCRT, right? In the 11th NCRT, they have given many topics beautifully. The topic of India-China. How India and China which got freed at the same time. Their development path was, you know, how their development was path was different, that China became very large economy and India could not grow that much fast, right? So the comparative developmental evolution of India and China, that is given in the NCRT. If you are writing the answer about Indian economy, why Indian economy is weak, you can write a couple of points from that part, right? So NCRT is very, very important. From the planning period also, in the NCRT, you will get separate discussion about agriculture sector, about industrial sector, foreign sector, then poverty and inclusion. For each and every area, they have given the planning period strategy in a detailed manner, right? So when you're writing the answer of industry, you should tell what was the strategy of Britishers, what was the strategy immediately after independence, what was the strategy after the 1991, and what is the recent strategy. So in the Britishers time, we were having very few Indian industries. Those were located only in few areas like cotton industries, right? Private sector was weak, right? Public sector was dominating under the Britishers. Our industry was demolished because of drain of wealth theory, right? Our economy was systematically deindustrialized. So there was rampant unemployment. Industry was very, very weak. At the time of independence, in the second five-year plan, we followed Mahalanobis model, where we established big industries, and we thought that those big industries will provide the employment and they will be a catalyst to the development of the private sector also, right? After that, in 1991, we changed the policy, and in the recent time again we changed the policy. Recently we are now in the era of IR 4.0, Industrial Revolution 4.0, where we are talking about artificial intelligence, Internet of Things, cloud computing in the industrial area, right? So this is how you can develop your answer. And my friend, I am not saying you need to write 100 words on this. You can just write 2-3 line, and those 2-3 line will make a, you know, major difference in your answer. Your answer will be quality apart from all other people, right? So that is how you can incorporate from the already existing resources. Economic History of India, from some of the books like Kaushik Basu. Kaushik Basu has written very beautiful booklet, that is New Oxford Companion to Economy, right? So in this book, which is having two volumes, Kaushik Basu has stressed many areas like disinvestment, like poverty, unemployment, population, and for each topic he has given critical analysis that what got missed in the India's strategy, right? Alternatively, you can use the book of Bipin Chandra. The name of the book is India Since Independence, right? Even there is a NCRT, right, with the same name, India Since Independence, 12th class, right? So you can use this NCRT. In this NCRT, you will find the debate between public and private sector, the debate between industry versus the agriculture, why industry was given the prominence after the independence and not the agriculture. There is a very good discussion about green revolution, right? So those things you can find in the NCRT itself. And if you write just one or two line in your answer, I am telling you, that is how you can increase your marks from 100 to 140, 150, right? So I'm not saying you need to refer to new sources. Just be aware, be alert, and use your already existing sources. Uma Kapila, in case you have done, you have read this book, then you can refer to this. If you did not read so far, then no need to read it. right? In this book, Uma Kapila has given a critical analysis of important government schemes, right? So that gives us a deep understanding about various policies, because in the recent time, the policies are also being asked in the examination. So even if we do not get exact points from the Uma Kapila, we actually get some critical line of thinking, that how to think, how to critically analyze the government scheme, right? Then there is a book of Mishra Puri. All these book, I'm not saying you should read all of them, all of these book. At least you should read this book of India Since Independence and this NCERT of 11th class. You should read these two book. And for Kaushik Basu, Uma Kapila, if you find some time, you can refer to a couple of topic, or like you can see my notes, my class notes. I have covered each and every topic from these books, right? Now, there is a very good thing from the okay. So Karthikeyan is asking, for policies, won't it be enough to refer current affair? My friend, I have seen multiple times, current affair is sufficient, no doubt, but you get average marks because everyone is writing same thing. You are writing the same point, your friend is writing the same point, everyone in the examination hall is writing the same point, you get the average marks. So what I'm saying is, you need to add some value to your own answer. If you get some extra points of thought, then you can get extra mark. And I'm not saying that you need to write extra point in the examination, but you need to write unique point. You need to write unique point. That is how you can get the extra mark. You write just 3 point, not an issue. Each and every point should be unique and very much relevant to the what has been asked, right? It should not be written just for the sake of, you know, filling the answer sheet. Now, syllabus has been given in detail. This is a very good aspect, right? Food processing and related industries, location upstream, downstream, everything. Like you can see in the food processing, we have to know about the related industries. We have to know about the scope, significance, location, upstream, downstream, supply chain. We have to know all of, about all these things, right? So this is a very, very comprehensive detailing of the syllabus. So this is a good thing, because unlike prelims, in the prelims they have just written one or two line and then they're asking everything from the macroeconomy. But in the GS3 paper, at least they have mentioned each and every detail of the syllabus, so that you can restrict yourself to these areas. Then there is overlapping with the other subjects. For example, there are many topics. Groundwater. This groundwater is in the GS3 paper also, in the GS1 also. Pollution, GS1 also, GS3 also. Then we have the topic of poverty, in the GS1 also, GS2 also, GS3 also, right? Then there are various other areas. For example, in the essay paper, you will find at least one essay from any of the area, either from the economy or science and tech, or maybe from foreign investment, from MSME. Like you will find at least one essay from the GS3 topics. So if you prepare GS3 in the detailed manner, you are automatically preparing one of your essay. So this is the strength of the GS3 paper. Now, what is required? How to master the GS3 paper? How to get 140 plus marks? First of all, you should have crisp notes. My friend, having 3-4 pages on any topic will not give you time to revise in the examination time. And you will get confused at the time of revision. So you should either make your own notes through diagrams. Aap jo hai diagram banao, right? Diagram banao, mind map banao, apne khud ke notes banao, sirf ek page par. A4 size ka paper lo aur apne haath se us pe notes banao. Theek hai? Wo best tarika hai. I understand you may not have the time to make notes on all the topic, but you can at least choose top 100 topic of the GS3 and make this self-made node on top 100 topics, right? Not on all topics, but at least on the top 100 topics. So top 100 topics pe to aap banai sakte ho na, itna to karna hi hoga na. If agar itna bhi nahi karoge to fir how will you get the marks? Then you should also do the answer structuring, right? So these top 100 topics, you make the notes of these 100 topics and do the answer structuring. What can be the possible introduction? What can be the possible body points? What can be the possible conclusion, right? So you may not have the time to write each and every answer to those questions, but at least making the structure will help you a lot. So Realme is asking, sir, how do we know which topics are important for mains? Very good question. So for that, first of all, I will say it will be always better if you take the questions from 2013 to 2019, that is 13 14 15 16 17 18 19 7 years multiplied by 20, that is 140 questions are already available from the UPSC side. Out of these 140, choose any top 50 topics, right? 50 topics which are being repeated or which are relevant to the current time also, because there can be some questions which are outdated, so ignore those questions, right? 50 topics from the previous year and 50 topics which are very much in news, highly in news. For example, the topic of disinvestment, right? For example, these days, what will be the impact of Corona on economy, right? So all these are very, very evolving issue, always in news, right? For example, about the fiscal management. For example, about the banking reforms. About the infrastructure, right? By the way, I will give you the list of top 100 topics in the month of June, right? So immediately after the prelims, I will bring out the list of top 100 topics so that the job becomes easy for you, right? So I will arrange that for you. Do not worry. Okay? You should get 360 degree view of every topic. You should know the background, pros, cons, challenges, arguments in favor, arguments against, right? You should have 360 degree view so that any type of question is asked in the examination, you can answer that particular question. Now, very, very important thing, how to do the value addition. Value addition, kaise karein? So, for value addition, you need to inculcate certain practices in your answers. And before you inculcate these practices in your answer, you need to compile these things at a single place. Aapko ek single place par ye sab cheeze likhni hongi for every topic. Important statistics and data. So there are various sources. For example, this economic survey. Economic survey gives very, very important data, very recent data. Then there are various rankings, reports. For example, what is the ranking of India in the FDI? What is the ranking of India in the World Happiness Report? Right? What is the ranking of India in the World Remittances? So you can get the detail about the ranking. Then important data about different sectors, about the agriculture, about the economy, about the science and technology, about the terrorism. All these data you need to, you know, have compiled at single place and keep using one or two points in each and every aspect of your answer. That will increase your marks. Committee reports. There are various committees. Always there are committees. For example, in case of FDI, there is Arvind Mairam committee, right? In case of border management, Madhukar Gupta committee. Right. So similarly, on all the areas, for example, even in case of PPP, there is a committee or committee of Kelkar, right? Similarly, in the environment also, there are many committees which are working on different areas. Then we have sustainable development goals. You should link your answer with the sustainable development goals, right? You should link your answer with the sustainable development goal. What is the agenda of sustainable development goal and what will be the how the government can achieve that in the particular context. This Niti Aayog is a very, very authentic source. Niti Aayog is giving very recent data, and this is coming from the government office. So it is the most authentic data, especially the strategy document, this India at 75. Please download this booklet, India at 75. Download this booklet, and I am promising you will get unique points. Aapko unique point milenge is booklet se. Aapko even like whether this is the topic of GS3, for example, energy, for example, road sector, railway, for example, unemployment, poverty, all these areas like housing, rural development, urban development, on all these areas, you will find what are the challenges of these sectors, what is the status, what government step should be taken. Very, very unique point. Even if you did not cover last 2 years current affair, you covered this area, these topics from this area, from this strategy document, I am promising you will get a lot of value, right? So I am already running this course of GS3. In GS3 course, I have included all the points from various statistics, from committee reports, from this strategy document, and then coming to the economic survey. Economic survey gives very, very critical analysis, especially the volume one. Volume one is very, very relevant. If you see the last 3 years economic survey, you will find this economic survey is talking about not only economy, but also about agriculture. Sirf economy hi nahi, agriculture ke bare mein bhi ye economic survey bata raha hai. Science and tech ke bare mein bata raha hai. Ye aapki environment ke bare mein bata raha hai. The relation between the agriculture and the climate change. Sustainable development, for the sustainable development, there is a separate chapter in the volume 2, right? So, economic survey is not limited to the economy and agriculture. It is also talking about other areas of the GS3 paper. Whenever you are writing any point from the economic survey, write one line in the answer that as per the economic survey 2019-20, this. Examiner will get impressed. Examiner will get impressed. Even if the point is very general, but if it is written from an authentic source, you get extra edge, right? Budget. Every year, budget is having certain theme. For example, this time, aspirational India, right? Focus upon the agriculture and other areas. So you should also remember the themes of the budget. This budget is becoming very, very important for the GS3 paper. Every year you will find minimum one question from the budget, directly or indirectly. Yojana. Yojana is very, very good source. So if you see recent months Yojana, there has been topic of urbanization, the topic of say this energy, topic of environment, right? All these topics, on all these topics, you will find at least two very, very good article. Or if you do not follow the article, you can at least read the preface. Jo first page hota hai yojana ka, usko achche se padho, usko underline karo. You will get lot of data, a critical analysis, and a 360 degree view of the entire topic from that one page of the yojana, right? And you should try to inculcate good data, good analysis from this yojana, which is very, very unique source. Theek hai? Similarly, there is a source of Kurukshetra. This is especially very, very good for the agriculture sector, right? So for example, in the month of October 19, this Kurukshetra came on the agricultural reforms, right? So you should inculcate the points from this Kurukshetra of the